ban on dodgeball in Windham has been lifted. Public outcry and petitions got school administrators to take a second look at the ban put into place back in March. Well, a committee recommended the games come back, but some school board members still worry they're violent and fuel bullying. Our Heather Hamill has more on tonight's decision and when the games will be back in gym class.
It was the last item on the agenda and one that school board members say they are happy to put to rest. In the end, it was a compromise of sorts, making changes to some games in order to allow them to be played. But still, not everyone was completely happy.
Is that really the best we can do? That we're going to evaluate our kids on the ability to throw things at other children?
School board member Stephanie Wimmer still had concerns about human target games played at Windham schools despite a committee's recommendation to reinstate them. She was in the majority in March when the board voted to ban the games amid safety and bullying concerns. But after students got hundreds of signatures on petitions, a committee looked at the issue again and have now recommended changes. Game names that had a violent undertone will be changed.
Specifically, at the middle school level, the game of slaughter has been changed to the name Numero Uno. Specifically, at other levels, the game of prison ball has been changed to repair shop.
And for those who don't feel comfortable playing the games, there will be alternatives.
We can have children working with other responsibilities within the team. They can be working on other activities.
Erin Shirley is a PE teacher at the middle school and says the games, which involve a Nerf ball, are only played a few times a year and rarely do they see injuries. And as for a student's comfort level, she says it isn't limited to just these games.
A lot of times those students have the same issues when they come up to bat in a softball game or if they're going to rotate into the serving position to play volleyball.
But one board member says this is a different concept.
We're talking about violence. We're talking about taking a ball, hitting someone. We're not talking about uncomfortable speaking in public. It's a different concept.
But the one board member who had voted against the ban saw it differently and said that he was pleased with the recommendation and the students who spoke up in the first place.
I am a proud dad that my kid was one of them, but there's a lot of proud parents up there. Their kid stepped up, made a difference, came forward, tried to work within the system.
The school board accepted the recommendation, but as for the topic getting this much attention, the chair called it all disappointing. Safety will be the utmost priority, but as long as the changes work, the plan is to allow the games next school year. Reporting in the studio, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.